Welcome back. We'll be looking at chapter 5.3, which is on energy analysis of steady flow system. Like what I've told you earlier, we only study on the steady flow system. Yeah. So what is a steady flow system? Okay. So we see process involved. In this syllabus, yeah, we'll be only looking at equipments like turbine, compressor, and nozzles, yeah, and mixers. What else? Let me see. Turbine, nozzles, diffusers, yeah, few equipments. Because these equipments are actually classified as steady flow device. Okay, so what is a steady flow device? I've covered that in chapter 1, right? Yeah, where a process during a flow through the volume is steady. Okay, so there is no change in the volume. Okay, so there's no change in time. There's a short form for to even understand better. Okay, so now going to this. So we have mass in, mass out, and then the flow is actually at steady condition. Yeah, so it remains constant. The volume, the control volume remains constant. Okay, what is control volume? Mass can go in and mass can come out, but there is a volume that is retained inside. Yeah, so this one will be control volume, and the volume condition inside here is at steady as well. Okay, so let's look at the formula where we have mass in equals to mass out, m1 equals to m2. Yeah, of course This is talking about total M in and total M out. So when you have mass in and mass out, it need not to be only one coming in and one going out. It can be more than one. But the most important is the summation. Okay. And what is mass flow rate? You remember mass flow rate is given by kilogram per second. So how do you achieve that? This is density, kilogram meter cube. And then you have the velocity. And then you have the area. So in total, what do you have? Meter cube per kilogram, and then it's not meter cube per kilogram, it is kilogram per meter cube, yeah, kilogram per meter cube, and then we have multiply with velocity and then multiply with area. So what do we have here? When you cancel off, you get 3 m's above, 3 m's below. So your unit will be kilogram per second. Okay. So that is how you do for your mass balance. Where is your energy balance? From the previous chapters, you remember what is energy balance? E in equals to E out. Yeah, when E in equals to E out, Q in, W in, this one in the middle. What is this theta here? This theta is your H. Your potential energy, this is kinetic energy, this is potential energy, yeah, you put in all together. Okay, so you come up with this, the main mother formula, and then you expand it, you get all this. Now in that question, if they don't mention about potential energy, so you strike out. So, but you still need to write, yeah, just strike out in the next line. Yeah, you put a point there beside there saying that they don't have any potential energy or they don't have kinetic energy, depending on the question. It's very subjective to the question. Yeah, okay, so this is the relationship, the same thing. Yeah, they're just further simplifying it. Okay, so we have each exit, each inlet. Yeah, this is just to rearrange. Yeah, what this one, now they put all the Q's and the W's on one side. So when you rearrange, you get like this. This is rate. When you have a dot up there, it means it's divided by time, second, or can be minute or hour. Commonly it's divided by second. Okay, so this is how it is. So there are cases where kinetic and potential energy are negligible, so you just cancel off. You can put in other form of energy, which is the work shaft or the work electricity on the quiz, in the equation itself. Well, this depends on the question. Okay, so now we're going to go on to 5.4, which is discussion on some steady flow of the engineering equipment. Now this is the most important chapter, because this chapter is the one where the questions from the final exam and test comes out from. Yeah. So there are many devices. We're going to pick few devices only. We're going to look at only steady flow devices. Yeah. Okay. So we're only looking at steady flow devices. Now this is gas turbine. Okay, just have a look at it. Yeah, gas turbine. Okay, now this is a nozzle and diffuser. What is the difference between nozzle and diffuser? Nozzle increases the velocity, whereas diffuser reduces the velocity. Example, your hose in the garden. If you want to wash a car, you want the water pressure to be really high, the velocity of the water to be high, you put a nozzle. Okay, whereas the same garden hose, if you want to water your plants, let's say you want to pour water on the soil of the pot, yeah, you cannot use a nozzle. And the moment you use nozzle, what happens? All the soil will come out from the pot, right? So you need to use a diffuser. Diffuser reduces the velocity. Yeah, so this is the explanation, increases the velocity, and diffuser reduces, slows down the the fluid itself. So the formula would be E in equals to E out. You start off with that. Okay, when you plug in all the, you remember the mother formula, you expand it, you come to these, right? You come to these. So that one, you simplify for the nozzle, you cancel off the potential energy, you cancel off the work, because there's no work one, and there's no heat transfer, unless they mentioned about the heat transfer. Okay, so the formula becomes MH, velocity. You can't ignore velocity because the fluid has got very high velocity either in the outlet or inlet, yeah, compared to the opposite one. So this is the formula for nozzle. I will go through all the equipment and then I will come to the examples. Yeah, examples. Okay, I'll go through the equipment. Now this is a turbine and compressor. So what is a turbine? Turbine actually produces work, mechanical work. It means fluid passes through the turbine and then work done against the blade. The blade will cause the shaft to rotate, and then the rotating shaft will produce work. That is a turbine. It produces work. Whereas a compressor and a pump, yeah, or a fan, yeah, it doesn't produce work. It needs electricity to actually move it. Okay. So a fan, you know what's a fan, right? Maybe now as you're watching this video, there is a fan above your head, isn't it? Okay, or maybe in front of you, I'm not sure. So the fan increases the pressure of the gas slightly, your fan. Okay, next would be compressor. Compressor compresses gas to a very high pressure. That's a compressor. Okay, like example, your fridge at home, the air conditioner has a compressor. Now pumps. Pumps is like more for... Yeah, pumps and compressors is almost a similar thing. But compressor works on gases. Okay, pumps works on liquid. So if you have a fish tank, yeah, if you have a fish tank at home, so you have a water pump, right, inside there. So that is a pump. Okay, so the energy balance for a compressor, work in, of course. Compressor needs work, because it needs electricity or work in, yeah, plus with MH1, Q out, plus MH2. This one, of course, you cannot cancel. This one depending on the question. If they say there is a Q out, then you write that. If they say there is a Q in, then you write that. Yeah, that this is really very dependent on the question itself. You will see some examples shortly, yeah. Okay, before I go into throttling valve, what I will do, I will go into the examples of nozzle and diffuser. So this is the first example, the diffuser. Okay, so we have air at 10 degrees and 80 kilopascal enters the diffuser of a jet engine steadily with a velocity of 200 meter per second. The inlet area of the diffuser is 0.4 meter square. So inlet area is 0.4 meter square. So you write down, extract out the information. All this information is very important. Yeah, maybe you want to use a highlighter, or you want to write it down in a piece of paper. Yeah, but when you solve for your exam, you have to write it down. Yeah. So the air leaves the diffuser with a velocity of very small compared with the inlet velocity. So it means, you see, yeah, the air leaves the diffuser with a velocity that's very small. It means your V2 is so small compared to V1. So you can actually call your V2 as zero also. Now that is the meaning of the sentence there. So what you need to calculate here, look at the thing, what you need to calculate here is the mass flow rate of the air and the temperature of the air leaving the diffuser. These are the two things that you need to calculate. Okay, so this is the explanation, what is diffuser and all this thing. So let's work on calculating. So for a diffuser, what is the formula for diffuser? Okay, remember this is the formula for diffuser. You always start off with this and then you expand. So did they talk about any Q going into the diffuser? Don't have. No work that's done. There's no potential energy. So that's why it's all being cancelled. But of course, the velocity you have to take into account. Yeah. But the second velocity you can ignore because it's so small compared to the first one. Okay. So the first step is to find all your, you need to find your H, right? Now velocity, no problem. It's actually given, I think, in the question. Let me see. The velocity is given. So you need to find the H. Before you can find the H, what do you need to do? You need to find how to use the steam table. So these are the properties that you need to find. Yeah. Like example, in this case, you need to find the V first. Yeah? Using your PV equals to RT, you find the V1, which is 1.015. And then you take the value. Okay. You put into here. You multiply with the velocity and you multiply with the area, you get your mass flow rate. Okay, keep that aside. Yeah, keep the mass flow rate aside. Okay, so now from this formula, okay, you have your mass flow rate ready. I'm going to highlight what you have. You have this, you have the velocity that's given in the question. Okay, and then of course, this one you have. This one you can say zero because the second velocity don't have. Yeah, okay. Now, what you don't have is your H2. That is what you need to find, isn't it? Yeah, that's what you need to find. Now, H1. How do you find H1? Okay, you need to go to the steam table. Yeah, now this is air, so you need to go to table A17. Okay, remember like previous lessons, what are the criteria that's given? You always need 2 points, yeah? 2 points. So in this case, what? Air 10 degrees and 80 kilopascal. Okay, 10 and 80 kilopascal. So you go to your steam table. Okay, where's your steam table? At the back of your textbook, right? Okay, you go to table A17. Okay, see. Highlighter is on. I'm going to cancel that. Okay, table A17. A17, there's a lot of things that's being highlighted. Delete everything. Okay, just ignore that. Okay, the temperature is 10, isn't it? Just now 10 is 10 plus 273 is 283. So it's somewhere in between here. Okay, so you need to interpolate. Remember Okay, you remember how to interpolate, right? I've taught you just now in the last video. So here the question is actually asking you for at 283, yeah. So 283 is somewhere in between here. You need to find the V, table A17. Wait a minute. 1 second, table A17. Okay. Table A17. Okay, so I'm going to guide you. Look at this. You're looking for 280, isn't it? 283. Yeah, so it's in between this and this because this is the H value. Okay, what you do, very simple. You just need to copy this to the and do an interpolation. So how to do interpolation? You have temperature, you have enthalpy, you have 280, and then you have 285. What you're looking for is 283, right? Okay, then you copy back this one, 280.13, 285.40. 280.13. This is an x, you don't know. This is 285.14. Almost the same value. Okay, 14. So now you find the x value. You know how to do that, right? Remember what I told you? These minus these. 283 minus 280 equals to x minus 280.13 divide by. Then you take the second set. 285 minus 280. Okay, equals to 285.14 minus 280.13. You solve, you get this. Okay, so the first part of the question, we have done already. Okay, the question is actually asking for the mass flow rate. We have done. Okay, temperature, right? Okay, temperature. So now we have got the H really. Now we got the H. We solve for the H2. Plug in and you solve for the H2. Okay, you got your H2. What do? You take this H2. You go back to the same table. Okay, and you find where is the H2 value? 303. So where is 303? 303. You go down. Okay, 303 is in between these two, isn't it? So you can interpolate. Yeah, do the same thing. You find the temperature. Okay, so that's done with the first question. Next, we're going to move on with the question of compressor. Yeah, we're going to move on to the question with compressor. So let's solve the compressor question. Okay, 100 kilo Pascal and 280 compresses steadily at 600 and 400. The mass flow rate is 0.02. So given mass flow rate, the heat loss Q out. It's given as 16 kilojoule per kilogram. So with that, can you see this diagram? This is a very good diagram that you need to draw in the exam. It's very, very important. You draw like a free body diagram and you label and you write them. You write all the information that you have extracted out from the question. It's very important, yeah, the schematic diagram. So with the schematic diagram, what is the question that they want you to solve? Necessary power input to the compressor. So how much power in to the compressor? They're actually asking you for a power in. Okay, so let's look at the working. Let's look at the working, yeah. Okay, so we always start off with the mother formula, which is E in equals to E out. Okay, we have done that. Okay, this you write the formula and remember the compressor. What was the compressor's formula in the lecture note? Yeah, this is the compressor's formula. Let's say, okay, that is your compressor's formula in your lecture note. Take it out, put here. Okay, what do you have? You have Q out, right? They've mentioned in the question. You see, when it's in the diagram, picture form, it becomes very easy. You can just plug in the values and you can solve it even easily. So the question that they want is actually power input. So how much power has gone in? Yeah, so they want W in. Okay, so that's done. So how do you get your H1 and H2? You look at this, you go to the steam table. You look at this, you go to the steam table. Careful, this is air. Yeah, it's not water. So steam table is A17. Table A17. You go there, you get this value, these two values. Then you plug in into the formula. Okay, then you can get your work in. So that's how you solve, yeah. So it's very, very dependent with the steam table, okay. Next, I'm going to continue the lecture note with other equipment. So we have covered nozzle, diffuser, we have covered turbine compressor. Then we're going to go into throttling, valve and mixers later. Also heat exchangers. Okay, throttling valve is a kind of flow restricting devices that causes significant pressure drop in the fluid. Guys, it's not so complicated. You know your house tap? That tap is throttling valve. Okay, there are many types of valve. Eh? There's porous plug, there's capillary tube, there's adjustable valve. It all depends on the industry. What is appropriate to them? Based on that, they will have a valve. Okay, so the formula for it is NG. Of course, mass balance is very simple. Mass 1 equals to mass 2. Simple, finished story. Energy balance is what you need to write, where H2 equals to H1. You don't have a Q, you don't have a Q in, you don't have a Q out. If they mention, you plug into the thing. But if they don't mention, it means they don't have anything. Okay? Mostly also no potential energy. Kinetic can be, but it depends. But mostly on a valve, they don't even talk about kinetic energy. So the formula of energy balance is this. Okay? Next, a mixing chamber. Looks very complicated, right? You know, your house, some of your houses have got solar panel above your roof. For those kind of houses, the hot water will flow in, yeah, into the tap. And then you see your tap, your tap is unique. If you turn to the right, maybe then you have cold water. If you turn to the left, then you have fully hot water. You put in the middle, 50-50. You depend, where you, if the day is very cold, then you go towards the hot water, more inclined to the hot water. That's a mixer. You have this at home. Yeah, some of the houses. If you don't, then you would have checked into a hotel before, you would have seen this before. Yeah. So the energy balance for this, this mass balance, you have a mass, because you know why? Mass 1, mass 2. Yeah, mass 1 plus mass 2 equals to mass 3. Okay. So that's the reason why energy balance, MH1 plus MH2, M2H2, you have equals to M3H3. So in a mixer, most of the time, there is no heat transfer, heat in, heat out, no work in, work out, no electricity, nothing. Yeah, no KE, no PE. Well, it depends. If the question mentioned it, then yes. If otherwise, forget about it. The formula becomes simple as this. Okay. Next, we have heat exchanger. You know what's a heat exchanger? Yeah. In your car, like example, in your car and all, you have a radiator, right? The radiator is to cool down your car engine. Yeah, car engine. So that radiator in front there, if you see the liquid in the radiator doesn't get contact with the air. It, there's like two different pipelines that's running. One is the air that is touching the radiator's tubing, which will cool down the radiator fluid itself, isn't it? So that is a heat exchanger. The fluid A will not touch fluid B. So in a car radiator, what do you have? You have radiator, right? And then you have the tubing. So let's say the tubing is liquid B. Fluid A is your air surrounding the car. Okay, so you have fluid A. Fluid A doesn't touch fluid B directly. There is just a heat exchange only between both of them. So that is a heat exchanger. Most of the time, the liquid and the liquid will not touch. The fluid and the fluid will not touch each other. It is just, just like indirect contact. Okay, so that's a heat exchanger. Now the formula for heat exchanger is going to be a bit unique, because you know why? You have fluid one and fluid two. So fluid one can be water, fluid two can be refrigerant, depending. Fluid one can be also air. Yeah, depending. Yeah, okay. So in this case, you see, when mass in, this fluid will not touch or will not mix with this fluid. So that's the reason. Yeah, this is separate. Okay, the only heat exchange on the surface only. Okay, so that's why mass balance is this way. Yeah, two different equations. But the energy balance, you can mix it up. Okay, so you have what? M1H1 plus M3H3, because this two is going in and this one is the going out. Okay, M2H2, M4H4. Can you see this? Yeah, 2 and 4 going out. 3 will be, 1 and 3 will be going in. Okay, so that's the formula. Next, we have pipe and duct. Some piping line will have electrical. Okay, I give an example where, let me think about it. Oh, okay, let's say you're transporting margarine. Margarine, you know margarine, right? In room temperature, it's solid, right? Okay, so this lorry, if it's carrying some fatty acids or some margarine and all this thing, yeah, it's, when you reach the destination, you will see the residue in your tank. Sometimes in the tank like that, the residue is solid down there. What do? You put a heating coil there, you melt it, so it's easier for the thing to flow out. Okay, that's why some pipe ducts will have electrical energy input. Yeah, the coil, heating coil. Yeah, otherwise they can modify anything. Most of the time they don't have, but some they may have. Okay, so with that, this is the energy balance for pipe and duct line. So we have electricity in plus with MH1. Yeah, MH1, MH2, you know, right? Okay, and then you have Q out. This one also depending. Sometimes it can be Q in, sometimes it can be Q out. If whatever they mention, you write down. Yeah, but this is the conventional formula. Okay, so with that, we have actually finished the syllabus. Okay, unsteady flow is not in your syllabus. I repeat, it's not in the syllabus. So your lesson stops at 5.4. Okay, now let's go back to the question. Okay, we're going to solve example 5.8. We're going to look at refrigerant, expansion of refrigerant 134A in a refrigerator. So refrigerant enters the capillary of tube in a refrigerator as a saturated liquid. Saturated liquid at 0.8. Important point, yeah, saturated liquid at 0.8. Throttled to a pressure 0.12. Can you see, you know, the pressure increase is throttled up to it's throttled down to 0.12. Yeah, determine the quality of the refrigerant. Quality of the refrigerant at the final state or the temperature drop during this process. Okay. Okay. Now you put your informations, right? So the best thing to do is to draw your free body diagram. Write all the functions in the first part, that's before the valve, and what is the second part. So in this case, your first pressure, so how you do your free body diagram, I'll just guide you. Very simple. You're not in arts class, so do not complicate things. Yeah. So you put like that one pipe there, you put P1, what is that? Okay, what is the condition? Saturated liquid, that's it. P1 is 0.8. megapascal. You write it neatly, yeah, because I'm using stylus here, so it's not neat. And then P2 coming out there, what is the value? 0.12 megapascal. Okay, and then we have what they say, what is the point here? Determine the refrigerant. So always remember enthalpy is the same, because this enthalpy and this enthalpy will be the same. That is the point for your for the expansion in the capillary tube. The enthalpy is the same. So can you find the first enthalpy? No? Yes, you can. You go to table A12. Why table A12? Because this is a refrigerant. You must be very careful. You must look at what is the fluid in the question, and based on that you go to the table. So once you find the value and all, okay, now you find for the second one, the exit. What is the key point? H2 equals to H1. So with that you can find your T set. Yeah, so with that, you see, the first part is saturated liquid. Okay, when the pressure is throttled to 0.12, this will become a mixture. So you need to find the X2. How do you find the X2? You got your HF, HG, you can find the quality, right? So once you find the quality, we know the temperature change. Okay, yeah, so the temperature change is from negative 22.32 to 31. So where the temperature drop is actually about 53 degrees. The change in the temperature. So that's how you calculate. If you have any issue at all, yeah, like in this point you may be a bit confused, what is this? But this is the criteria for a capillary tube. Yeah, capillary tube. So if you have any problem, do meet me during the consultation hours and do ask me. Please do all the questions that I've assigned to you. It's very important, because one or two of the equipment can come out in your final exam, and one or two of the equipment can come out in your test. Okay, so with that, we have ended chapter 5. Please complete all the questions. Okay, thank you.